Hello, my name is Caitlin Wiggenhorn, and I work with Texas Instruments as an applications engineer in the converters and controllers product line. Today, we are going to cover an introduction to buck features, and this introduction will focus on four key features: undervoltage lockout, enable, soft start, as well as reset or power good voltage monitoring. This will give an introduction into starting up TI's wide VM buck converters, as well as monitoring the output voltage. Undervoltage lockout refers to the conditions at which the buck converter remains disabled. Within the wide VM buck converter family, there are primarily two kinds of undervoltage lockout that will control when the device turns on. The first is the internal LDO must be capable of powering the internal nodes. And during startup of the device, the internal LDO is always powered by VN. Consequently, there will be a minimum VN spec which will correlate with the point at which the internal LDO is capable of turning on. Second is the enable UVLO. The enable UVLO will provide more flexibility to a system designer as a second form of control of when their device will turn on or off within their system. Enable can be used to enable or disable the device, either by pulling the voltage above a threshold or pulling the voltage below the turnoff threshold. There are three options when a designer is deciding how to connect their enable, how they want to control the turn on and turn off of their device. The first is connecting enable directly to VN. This means that the device will turn on whenever the LDO UVLO is achieved. Second is connecting enable to VN through a resistor divider to utilize the UVLO. This means that through sizing your resistor divider, you can control the turn on point, the VN in which the device will actually turn on. And we can go into an example of this in the next slide. And lastly, you can connect the enable to a controlled signal, such as from an MCU or some sort of control device, which is capable of sequencing the power on of this IC, possibly with additional ICs. Here you can see an example for calculating the enable resistor divider for the LM73605. For this device, the enable threshold for Vout, or the threshold at which enable will turn on the device, is 1.25 volts at maximum. And the desired level for the device to turn on is at 12 volts at VN. So when calculating the resistor divider, start by choosing R enable top. In this case, it's set to 100K, and then calculate R enable bottom. And what this means is now that you know the desired level and the maximum level for enable at which the device will turn on, you can calculate the voltage across R enable top and R enable bottom and set your resistor divider as you can see here. Internal soft start is implemented on all of our new wide VN devices. This feature is used to allow the device to directly power sensitive downstream devices such as sensors, MCUs, and this is because soft start is limiting the inrush current at startup, as well as eliminating the overshoot at the output voltage. There are two ways that we implement soft start in our devices. The first is through internal soft start. What this means is that you can see here in the dotted line, there is an internal soft start clock and an internal soft start signal, which is the ramp. When either there is not a soft start pin externally or the soft start pin is left floating, this means that the Vout signal will follow the internal soft start ramp. The second method is utilizing the external soft start pin to connect a capacitor. By connecting a capacitor, you're able to slow down the rise time even further, allowing more flexibility again for the system designer. Here you can see an example of calculating the capacitance needed for an external soft start design. And this is an example using the LM573605. You can check the data sheet and you find the equation C soft start equals the soft start charging current times the desired time. This value, the ISSC, will be found in the data sheet, and you can see here from the EC table where you would find this. And with this value plus your desired time, in this case was 50 milliseconds, you can calculate the necessary capacitance. For this specific example, it would be 100 nanofarad. The wide VM family offers a reset or power good pin, which can be used to monitor the output regulation. By pulling this pin high with a pull-up resistor, the system designer can monitor the Vout regulation. The wide VM portfolio uses two different types of features to prevent false flags, which are hysteresis and glitch protection. Glitch protection will mean that if there is a small short perturbation on Vout, this will not trigger your reset or your power good flag. Instead, if say there's a load transient, your power good will continue to remain high, and then once the output voltage truly falls out of regulation under any circumstance, then you would be notified by your power good or reset signal. Thank you for listening today.